In this beautiful time, I welcome again all my dear students to the session 5 of learning the chapter Structural Change. I request all my dear students to take the page number 11, as we have discussed together industrialization in independent India, which is given in the page number 11. So I request all my dear students to go through the last paragraph given in the page number 11. The central topic which focused or conveyed by this paragraph is India dreamt by Nehru. We all know that Jawaharlal Nehru was an illustrious personality in the history of India because he was a zealous or an ardent nationalist who wanted to bring the Indians with freedom. He decided that the Indians, they should feel the real meaning of freedom. We all know that India had been exploited by the British for 150 years. During that time, they exploited India, they destroyed the existence of India because they took many valuable things from India to Britain and other things. They exported India's valuable things to other countries. They brought capitalism. So, soon after the independence, when India was gifted with freedom, nationalists like Nehru was dreaming of an independent India which should achieve economic development. He dreamt that, first point given in this paragraph is, he dreamt that India is supposed to achieve economic development by means of giant steel dams and power stations. Nehru thought that India would achieve economic development by means of industries, by means of giant steel, by means of dams and power stations. Next point, Nehru, he wished that India should achieve economic development by means of industries, and he also wished that there was a dam named Bakra Nangal Dam. He wished that this dam would be one of the highest in the world. He wished that this dam would be one of the highest or biggest in the world. Second one, the dam would be built out of greatest difficulties. We know that soon after the exploitation affected by the British colonialism, it was very difficult for achieving economic development. So, nationalists like Nehru, he thought that there should be some industries, there should be some power stations, there should be some dams. By means of that, we can achieve economic development, we can achieve self-reliance, so that this dam would be built out of greatest difficulties, because it was needed much hard work for building one of the highest dams. Third point, the dam would be built on a beautiful land where men working hard, men should strive hard irrespective of class and caste. This was the famous dream dreamt by Nehru, that men should work together and there should not be any division in between them. There were divisive forces like class and caste. Nehru dreamt that the class and caste should not become the walls in between the workers who were working on the beautiful land where the dam would be built. This was the another a beautiful dream dreamt by Nehru, Jawaharlal Nehru. This is all about this paragraph where we have discussed together the dreams of Nehru, which was achieved later. And the next page, I request all my dear students to take the page number 12, and the main heading is Urbanization in Independent India. The first paragraph under this title focuses on the topic of urbanization means to growth. Urbanization is the path to growth. First point, after independence, urbanization was increasing in India. It was increasing in India. Second point, globalization leads to expansion of cities. We know that. And globalization means what? The markets in different countries are linked together, are connected together, so that we can achieve economic development. The Western markets are linked to that of India, so that we can achieve economic development. It will give rise to a job opportunity, so facilities will be improving, so there will be expansion of cities. Third point, by means of globalization, by means of urbanization, we can achieve our dreams like smart city. Smart city is one of the achievements done by India government. We know that, where facilities can be what we can say achieved by Indians, they can feel the facility to its highest peak. So smart city was caused by globalization, where facilities can be enjoyed by the people in India. And next paragraph focuses on the topic of urban effect on independent India. This perspective or view was given by a sociologist. His name is M.S.A. Rao was one of the sociologists who gives his opinion on the urban effect on independent India. He viewed that villages were exposed to urbanization. The villages which situated nearby the towns or cities, they were also undergoing urbanization. We know that the people who belong to such villages, they can go to the adjoining or nearby cities and they can also enjoy the urban life. The villages which were situated near to any city, which will get the facility. So the people who were living on such villages, they can go to the cities which will give them job opportunity. So their life also will change. Such villages gradually will become part of the facilities enjoyed by the urban people. Next point, we can go through the box 1.10, where we can see that urbanization arises job opportunity, which can be illustrated with a village called Madhopur. There is a village called Madhopur where urbanization could be achieved. The first point is that 77 out of 298 household have migrants, that is less than half of all migrants work in Bombay and Calcutta. Madhapur was a village and which includes a lot of migrants. 77 out of 298 household, they become part of the migrants, and which can be compared with less than half of all migrants work in Bombay and Calcutta. Next point, the people who were the migrants who were working in other cities or villages, and who went to other from their village, who went to other cities and towns, they were sending money to their villages and they were visiting their villages. And third point, some immigrants lived in Africa and British towns. Some people, they went to other cities in India, they are called migrants. Some out of India, they are called immigrants. So this kind of activities done by the people who were living in villages, they brought prosperity to their homes by sending money to their villages. And in page number 14, we can observe two charts. The first chart gives you details about increase in the number of urban population and urban agglomerations. The second chart gives you the details about percent share of urban population, which is increasing, but decennial growth rate of the urban population is decreasing. We can see many things. There are two charts where we can see. In the first chart, we can see in 1951, around 17.29% of India's population, that is 62.44 million people, were living in 2843 towns. In 2011, 31.16% of India's population, which is 377.10 million people, who were living in 7,935 towns. It means what? The number of agglomeration or towns, which is increasing. I wanted to repeat it again. Agglomerations means what? The towns or municipalities linked to an urban area by means of transport route. There were some towns or municipalities which are situated near to a city, which can also become part of the facilities enjoyed by the people in that city, because the same transportation route is there. Where we can see the first chart, as I already told you, that there is an increase in the number of urban population. The people who were living in urban and nearby urban area increasing, and also towns or municipalities linked to urban area, their number also is increasing. There is a data in 1951, it was 17.29% of India's total population who were living in 2843 towns. But in 2011, the percentage of people who were living in urban area and the number of towns which had been linked to the urban area, number also increasing. The second the chart shows the percentage share of urban population is increasing, but the 10 years growth rate is decreasing. We can see when we compare when we observe the chart, we can see the decennial growth rate of urban population is declining. When we compare the data from 1981 to 2001, we can see the urban population of 10 years is decreasing. And for example, in 1951, the percentage of people who were living in 10 years data can be given. In 1951, it was 41.42% of what we can say urban population. And in 2011, it becomes 31.80. It means what? The decennial growth rate of the urban population is decreasing. This is all about this session. In this session, we were going through some of the important points, and after this, we can go through the question and answers which are given at the end of this chapter. And here we have, what we can say, discussed some of the important points. First, India dreamt by Nehru. The second point, urbanization is the means to growth. Third point, urban effect on independent India. And the last point we were discussing was that of the two chart. There were two charts given in the page number 14. And the first chart gives you the details where there is increase in the number of urban population. The urban population is increasing. The number of people who were living in urban area, their number is increasing. And also the urban agglomeration towns, the number of towns also increasing. Again, I wanted to tell you the meaning of agglomeration. Agglomeration means what? There are some towns or municipalities which are situated near to a city, and which are linked. The towns or municipalities linked to the city because it is coming in the transport route. So the first chart shows you increase in the number of urban population and urban agglomeration towns. For example, in 1951, when we look at the chart, we can see in 1951 there were 17.29 of India's population who were living in 2843 towns. In 2011, the percentage is increasing from 17.29 to 31.16. It means the percentage of people who were living in urban area increasing, and also the number of towns also increasing. So, in 1951, it was 2843, but in 2011, it became 7935. It means the number of agglomeration towns also increasing. It means the number of towns or municipalities linked to cities, their number also is increasing. And second chart gives you the details where we can see the percentage share of urban population is increasing, but the decennial growth rate of the urban population is decreasing. For example, when we go through the data, we can see from 1981 to 2001, the decennial growth rate of urban population is declining. It means what? The 10 years growth rate. It means within 10 years, after 10 years or after 10 years, the urban population is declining. And another next data we can give, the decennial growth rate of the urban population is declining, which is given in the chart. We can see in 1951 41.42 was the decimal growth rate, and in 2011 it became 31.80. This is all about this chapter. I might believe that all my dear students are going through the chapter very well, and you can read the chapter very well, you can learn the chapter very well. You have to play your role of learning this chapter. Now I would like to go through the question and answer. The first, I request all my dear students to take the page number 15. The first question: how has colonialism impacted our lives? We can either focus on one aspect like culture or politics, or treat them together. Already we have gone through sessions which can give answer to this question. First of all, I wanted to give the meaning of colonialism. Colonialism means what? The establishment of rule by one country over another country. India was visited by the British. They established their rule over India, and the Western colonialism had impact on countries like India, because India had been visited by many groups, especially the British, and they brought industrialization, they brought urbanization, they brought capitalism, and which was far-reaching. The influences given by the British were far-reaching in India. Still, it is what we can say prevalent in India. And normally the country who visit another country and established their rule over countries like India, they are stronger. The British, they are stronger, and at that time India was a weaker country. That's why they could establish their rule over India. And during that time they influenced Indian society culturally, socially, emotionally, and still which can be seen in Indian societies. The influences given by the British, still it can be felt in Indian society, because there is a British model accepted by Indians, like because of colonial effect, like what we can say, there is a parliamentary and legal system which was influenced by the British. There is a police, there is educational system. We followed the educational system gifted by the British, and we are driving on the left side of the road, and we like food items like bread omelette and cutlets, and there were some manufacturers of biscuit which named after Britain. The name of the brand is what we can say Britannia, and we are wearing uniforms with neck ties, which is also influenced by or given by the British colonialism. Next important point is, we can say the British, they influenced all spheres of social life, especially the language English. English was the one of the beautiful gifts given by the British to India. It has significances, and the language shows some paradox, as I have already told you that what is the paradoxical nature of British Western education in India. And there are some Indian writers who are writing in English, and their writings become very illustrious all over the world. There are writers in India, their writings became very famous because they could write in English, and in English is the window to global market. And if you want to have a link between Indian market and foreign market, English, the language English, plays a wider role. Next point, English marks as a what we can symbol of privilege. Those who can speak English, those who can write English, it is considered that it is a mark of privilege. And if you know English, you will be what we can say facilitated by what we can say job opportunities. there will be job opportunities if you have access to this language. Next, in the next point, now at present time we can see that everybody irrespective of class and caste, they have access to this language. Even though in the what we can say in the past, groups like religious groups like Dalit, and they were formally denied to learn this language. Now everybody has access to this language. This is all about what we can say the answers to this question. I request all my dear students to go through the session I taught you. That will be helpful for you to write the answer. The second question is, industrialization and urbanization are linked process. Discuss that. We can go through the answer. We can understand that what we can say, the meaning of this question is, industrialization and urbanization both are influence each other, both are connected each other. We can understand that industrialization and urbanization, they took place as a part of development of modernization. We know that India became modern because of industrialization and urbanization. Industry started in India, which brought urbanization. For example, in an area where an industry started, a lot of people will be coming there in search of job. So there will be facilities around that places. There will be shops, there will be hospitals. So such facilities will be starting in that particular area. So that area will be become populated. So gradually that area will become an urban area. So industrialization causes urbanization, which is a part of modernization. Next point, when modernization happens, when industrialization happens, when urbanization happens, lot of what we can say technological development will be there. Technology can be used in what we can say industries and the offices. Due to urbanization and industrialization, technological development will be there, and there will be arrival of large scale industries. There will be emergence of cities, and what we can say, there will be people who will be coming from nearby villages to the places where industries are there. So the cities can offer job opportunity to the people who were coming from villages. The towns situating nearby the cities can converted to cities. It means what? The towns, because of industrialization and urbanization, will be transformed into cities because of the growth of population. And means of transportation and communication also will increase because of industrialization and urbanization. This is the answer to this question. I request all my dear students to go through the question and answers. I request all my dear students to go through the chapter. It will give you knowledge, and you can what we can write the examination in a proper way. In the future also, this knowledge will help you to become a proper social being. So go through the chapter again. If you have any queries, later we can discuss. So I request all my dear students to learn from the chapter in a proper way. God bless you. Thank you.